Play the background. I'm feeling that beat right there. Oh. Oh. Yes, y'all. What's going on? It's your boy, Big Rich the Ruler. IXS Radio. We back, y'all. Yo, give me some more. I need some more of that, Al. Turn it up, Al. I gotta feel that. Whoa. Hey. Whoa. Hey. Whoa. That's all right, Al. Let me go back to my day. And you're gonna bring that back. I'm not free, Big, because I'm not gonna need to bring that back in, alright? What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Big Rich the Ruler, man. And I'm back. The Ruler Show. Cal Riff, what's going on? Rob Ace, what's going on? Dee Dee, what's going on? It's your boy Big Rich the Ruler. I'm back, man. We back, new station, new things, new flavor. We got new music in the background. Y'all better watch what's going on, man. It's the Ruler Show, man. I'm back, man. We got more topics, we got more things ready to pop off, you know what I'm saying? Feeling good this morning. Yo, Al, hit me with some more of that. Turn it up, Al. That's crazy right there. Watch me live, y'all. I'm live right now. One. Talk to me, Al. Hey, yo, Al, they said that we won't be able to see you no more, man. What's good with it? Yeah. Okay. Wow, that beat is crazy. Everybody's texting me. Yep, I'm back. Big Rich the Ruler Show. We back, y'all. We doing what we do, yo. Hey, yo, Al, your mic is on? Can I leave?
Of course, man.
Yeah, come on, man.
You know how we do. Ain't nothing changed, bro.
Yeah.
That's,
it feels real good to be up in the new station, man. I just want to say we are truly blessed. That's how we're going to start this out right now.
Right.
We are truly blessed to bring people what they want to hear every week. The Big Rich the Ruler Show, IXS Radio. We was out for a couple of weeks because we switched locations. But now we at the new spot, man, and I'm happy, man. It's a, you know, it's a, it feels good to have our own spot. You
absolutely,
know what I mean?
Absolutely, absolutely.
I mean, I want to thank the people that held us down. I'll go back to the beginning, yo. What was the spot on Fordham again?
Tub City.
I want to thank Tub City for, you know, holding us down. And DITC, I want to thank y'all for holding us down once again. But now we got our own spot, new location, new things. We got a lot of new shows coming, too. A lot of new shows are coming. We got my man Chris the Boss, Boss Radio coming. We got somebody that's coming back that I love, yo. We working on that. Al, I'm not going to drop the bomb yet, you know what I mean?
Right.
We're going to hold off on some of the things, but we got some new shows, new location, new things going on. And that's what it is up here, man. We got some new topics. We're going to talk some love things today, you know. We're going to let Al get into a little musical thing. It's funny because at the new location, I'm so used to everywhere I was, you know, working with Al. I see Al, but right now, he's in the back, you know what I mean, working the boards. You know, he'll be up here later on, but right now, it's about the ruler, yo. Y'all already know, man.
Yeah, it's about the ruler, man.
Hey, yo, Al, so, man, a lot of things I want to talk about, man. Bring it down.
Just before you get started, man.
Talk to
me. We just need to let them know that the track you're hearing in the background is a DOE, Big Al original production. You know what I'm saying? That's how we used to get down, man.
All those years,
man, in the music industry, we still got it. And that's how we coming, man, with some original stuff, man. Nothing big, nothing already heard. But we're going to give you the flavors of IAXIS Radio.
Hey, yo, that's crazy right there. Yo, once again, man, I just want to say, yo, we truly blessed, man. I was talking to one of my friends, right, and we was talking about this internet radio situation. And he's an entertainer, and he was saying that most of the music that's being heard right now are heard through stations like this, you know what I mean?
Right.
Once again, they're not able to get on the air and do what they want to do on their stations. So, you know, they have to, you know, come to stations like this and rock with us, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Excuse me. I'm working with an artist right now. I don't like to jump into too many different lanes. But an artist came to me and was like, yo, Rich, listen, I want you to work with me, man. I'm gonna get this music out. And like I said, I like to do my homework on everything I do before I do it.
Right.
So I've been studying the craft of being, like, you know, an A&R as well as a manager for an artist, a young lady. Yo, her music is crazy right now. She's an R&B artist. She tried to do a little rapping, you know, in between. But her lane is wide open, man. And like I said, it's a beautiful thing, man. I got to make sure that I know the craft before I really get into it. But right now, that lane is wide open, man. We always keep talking about the R&B lane, bringing it back to where it was at.
Right, right.
Well, right now, Al, I got one right now.
But that's what's up.
I got one right now.
That's what's up.
I want to say special shout out to the people that's been holding me down. They definitely, my man Chris, what's going on? Marcia, how you doing? Dee Dee, what's going on? My man Black, what's going on? Everybody's in. Ingrid, what's going on? How you doing, boy? Hey, hey. Slick Watch, what's going on, boy? I'm going to give a special shout out to my man, Si. It was his birthday yesterday, so happy birthday, Si. My man Hot Rod Strickland, what's going on? My little nephew, Dane, what's going on? Dane, I see you. Lakia, what's going on? Coco, hey, boo, how are you? My cousin Shanice, I see you, ma. Beverly, Denise, everybody's checking in early. Yep, Cal Rifkin, what's going on, boy? Cal Rifkin, he rocks with Rob Bates. They're on the road right now. So, Cal, what's going on, man? Like I said, we got to get you up to the station. Deja Blue, what's going on, boy? How you doing? It's been a while since I heard from you. Who's else on the line? My man, once again, my man Chris. Lisa, how you been? Barbara, hey, Barbara. Adrian, what's going on? Ricky, well, hey, Rick. Rick, it's funny because when I leave here, I'm over there to you, bro. My man Rick with the restaurant. Man, what's the name of the restaurant again? Oh, man. Shit. Hey, Rick, catch me the name of your restaurant because I'm on my way there as soon as I leave here. I swear I'm on. That's what I was thinking about. Rich Walker, yo, what's going on, man? Rest in peace to your brother, man. John, man, that's my dude, man. So once again, what's the name of Rick's restaurant? Something Girls. Wow. Hey, Rick, hit me up the name of your restaurant so I can shout you out. The best seafood restaurant out right now, man. Once again, Big C, what's going on from ATL? What's going on, homie? Nisha, what's going on? How you doing? Everybody's checking in early. So, yo, Al, let's get into my first topic today.
All right. Yo, I'm with it, man. Whatever you want to do.
Yeah, come on, Will man. Bronx, Will Bronx.
I'm excited, man.
Will Bronx, what's going on, bruh? Pro, what's going on?
What's up, Pro? What's up,
Will? Oh, shit, I said Pro. Look who walked in the building.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
My man Will Bronx, he's on check-in. My man Pro's in the building. I feel good. I'm back. What's going on? I'm back. All right, so let's get to this first situation, Al. Cut the music down a little bit. Cut it down a little bit. Because I got to get into some things right now. So, yo, the first thing I want, my first topic this morning, once again, here we go back with the same situation where I'm working in a spot. I see somebody coming in. That's not right. It gets to the point now. Al, we talk about this like it's like every other week. Everybody know I work in one spot. Like, why would you come there with somebody else? Seen them. Okay, spoke to the person. She spoke to me. She told me what the situation was. She was like, yo, listen, we going through something. I'm doing me. He doing him. Am I wrong? Am I right? Should I get into it? Should I leave it alone? What are we doing, Al? I mean, once again, if I tell on her, then I'm wrong. If I don't tell on her, then I'm wrong for him. I got to do something, Al. Seriously, I got to do. It's weighing on me heavy this morning that I seen her. But listen, Al.
I'm listening.
She was 100 with me.
Okay.
She said, we going through something right now.
Mm-hmm.
He doing him, I'm doing me.
Right.
So I said to her, well, you know I seen you. How you think I should feel about this? She said, Rich, you got to feel the way you want to feel. Do what you want to do. Am I saying something or am I minding my business, Al?
So right now, if she's saying to you
mm-hmm.
that they going through something,
going
he doing
through
her and she doing her, mm-hmm. you know, then you should leave it alone because they already got an understanding.
No, but what you mean an understanding?
That's what she said. You said that she said she's doing her. They're going through something right now.
They're going through something right now.
And she doing her and he's doing him.
Okay.
Okay, that means that right now is like, okay, yeah, they kind of still together trying to work it out.
Mm-hmm.
But they exploring other avenues.
Okay.
So if that's
so
the
me,
case.
So me being a homie, because I'm not going to say he went into my brothers. He's a homie. Me seeing a homie's girl out with somebody, you're saying fall back.
Fall back. But what you should have said to her is like, yo, are you sure he know what's going on? And
but
you
see,
ain't
that's,
just...
once again, I don't want to get into all
no,
that.
No, no, because she said to you.
Right.
She said to you.
Right.
That they was having some issues.
Right.
And that they kind of doing them.
Right.
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 And all you had to do is say, you sure? Because I don't want to have to say that I saw you and then it's going to be something else.
Okay. So once again, fall back.
Fall back.
Okay. I want to give a couple of more big shout outs because I see people checking in that's never been on my line before. Wanda Blue, how are you doing? Shelly, how are you doing? Nat Boo, hey, Nat Boo, what's going on with you? I'm going to hit Tony Cakes up in a little
Will
while.
Will Bronx, what's up, baby?
And my man Biz, I got to get them on the line. We're going to talk about some things today. Okay. So now, let's go to sports for a second because the sports game has been real interesting lately. All right, so we're talking about, you know anything about basketball? Because I don't.
Oh, man, stop. Let me tell you something about me in sports.
Oh, here we go.
Because I got to put it on the table for you, man. I've never been a spectator. I got to be involved in the game. If I can't be involved in the game, I can't sit there and watch somebody else play.
Basically, you don't know too much about the NBA, what's going on right now.
Not at all.
We're gonna hit that.
I heard about the Knicks firing somebody, but other than that, no.
Now, I got a prediction. I'm the first one to say that Mark Jackson, I'm just predicting this now, will be the next coach for the New York Knicks. I want this. I'm not a Knicks fan. I'm a Clippers fan.
I got you.
But the Knicks been down for so long.
Yeah.
That I really feel that it's the way they can make a come up is getting a coach that people would want to play for.
But see, they had an opportunity to keep Mark a long time ago, man. Why did they let him go?
Okay, no, Mark Jackson got caught up in some...
It don't matter, man. Nah, we're talking about his ability to be a player's coach, a coach, okay, and to help the franchise.
Okay, but this is something that I learned from you and Pro. This is something I learned from y'all. Timing is everything.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Our time is now. iAccess Radio.
Right.
Our time is now.
Right.
Mark Jackson's time is right now. It's time for somebody to come to New York and change this city around.
Mm-hmm.
And I think when him coming here, so many different other players in the NBA would want to come here because New York is the mecca of basketball. So if he came here, all them big top celebrities would want to come here. And everybody got to remember, Mark Jackson is the one who built, Golden State. He the one who put the Splash Brothers together.
Right.
He the one who brought all them guys together. So I'm telling you, he has a plan. New York has a plan. I'm a Clippers fan. But Knicks, I'm rooting for y'all on this. I just want to see y'all turn around. I'm tired of seeing y'all down for so long.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. It's been time since the Patrick Ewing fiasco.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? Uh-huh. Again, I don't know how he missed that layup. that was the thing that should have set the Knicks apart from all other basketball teams, and he blew it. So, again, it's time.
Okay. So, now, let me get into a positive note. I got some things I got to take care of. First thing is, come on, get some shout-outs, yo.
Bianca Butler, what's going on? We see you.
Okay, first thing I is...
Melissa, what's going on?
My man Uncle Burn. I got to hit my man Uncle Burn. I need Uncle Burn to call in.
Milo Centron, what's up?
We have a major, major, major announcement.
Yvonne Jeffries, we see you.
About this Uncle Burn situation. I need Uncle Burn to call in. As a matter of fact, let me text and tell him to call in. We have a major announcement going to happen. Besides the Bronx Day situation,
okay,
Uncle Burn got something really big coming up, and I just, glad to be a part of it. So, Uncle Burn, if you're listening, hit me up. I need you to call in. The number is 347-708-0216. iAccess Radio. Now, Al, once again, everybody know that we always end the show with a prayer. Last time we started the show with a prayer, so now we're going to do something a little different. In the middle of the show.
Okay.
I need a quick little prayer to bless us.
All right.
Now, one more thing. And I'm glad that Pro is here because I want to tell Pro this too. There was supposed to be a red ribbon at this door.
Oh, man.
We supposed to cut the ribbon. We supposed to have the champagne popping. We supposed to be up here celebrating. This is a celebration today. We had the new iAccess Radio.
Okay, we all that's coming.
Okay.
But we want to do it with the family. We want the whole team.
Yeah, we
here.
Need every you know what I mean? We gonna pop bottles. Let me tell you something. When Pro called me and said, "Yo, Rich, I got it." I'm like, "Okay, what you talking?" He said, "Rich, I got it. I found the spot. We home."
Right.
I'm like, "Okay, Al hit me up like, yo, Rich, I've been over there. I've seen it." I'm like, "Okay, if they like it, I'ma love it." I walked in here for the first time and I'm like, "Wow, this is it. This is us. We can do whatever we want up here. It feels great, yo."
Right.
And then this is another good thing I'm gonna say about this. Now, my brother Pro, I gotta put him on blast for a little minute. My brother Pro, when we was over at the other station, we barely seen him.
He was ghost.
He was ghost. He was a friendly ghost. We would hear from him.
Yeah.
He's a boss.
Right.
But we didn't see him.
Right.
I'm looking up now and I see my brother walking the door. It's a great feeling. Like, we're here. Three of the four is here.
Right.
And that's a great thing, man. We got, like I said, we got shows stopping by later on to confirm their spots. Okay, once again, if you want to be a DJ, if you want to be an whatever thing you want to do, we have time spots available. So, Al, I want you to explain to the people about the time spots that are available for DJs and MCs. You don't even have to be here.
Okay, so yeah, we have what's called a remote time slot where you could be home or you could send us an MP3 file or you could post that MP3 file yourself on your time slot. That time slot is going to be one day for 1 hour that same day every week for a phenomenal discount price. All y'all got to do is hit us up at iAccessRadio.com, Al at iAccessRadio.com, or hit me up on Gmail, doebrb@gmail.com, and we'll go over the particulars. We'll offer you an agreement, and we can get it going. The good thing about it is we can give you links to your show where you can just send it out to your people. You know, if you want to be on Facebook while you're doing it, whatever you want to do, you'll have an opportunity to say, "Look, I got a spot on an internet radio that's global. We're going around the world, and I want to be heard, so my people tune in." Okay.
Yeah. It's funny because I got two DJs.
Artie Green, what's good, baby?
Artie Green, my brother. It's your pops, boy. What's going on, yo?
Niecy Hollinsworth, we see you.
I got two shows that's ready to go. And I'm, like I said, me and you talked this week.
Right.
I want to start OB Music. He's going to start next week with one of the time spots. He said he wants to do his call the Thursday Traffic Jam. So he want to try to do something on Thursdays.
Okay.
I got another DJ, my man, Brian. I'm supposed to meet him later on today to pick up his money to start his show.
Right.
He does a lot of house music and stuff like that.
Okay.
I was supposed, DJ Kel One told me to hit him back this week with all the information. He wants to definitely get in. And I was told I got to hit my brother DJ Messiah.
Oh, that's what's up.
So we got the DJs coming in. You already know them. We got the Danny D's and all that.
Yeah, we got all that. Of course, we got our local, and we know people are going to be hitting us up. Mm-hmm. But the crazy thing is that we got this link and access to the global world overseas. My man hit me up from Italy the other day, man, who's got a crazy following over there. And he's like, "Yo, this is what I'm looking for. I see y'all got it. Let's do it."
Yo,
you know? But see, he's connected with so many people overseas. A matter of fact, he's getting ready to go do a full concert tour. And he's going to be promoting our radio station at his concert tour. That's going to be crazy.
Oh, that's crazy. You know? We're also working on, let me see, I just got a text. So, sis, I can't see that coming. You rock that out. We're also working on doing this showcase. Pros, he's still giving me the information on it. So we're working on the iAccess Radio Showcase. And I think Sis got a birthday party coming
up. Yeah, at Terrazza Saturday, 12/14/19, Rose Medallion's birthday celebration. Yeah, that's Rose Medallion from Got Rich Radio.
Got Rich
celebrating
Radio.
Her birthday.
Yes.
Big ups to her. Much blessings. Another year. You know, they doing some great things. Got Rich is a powerful team.
Yes.
They are no joke.
Yes.
Y'all need to tune in on Thursdays and check them out from 8 to 10. But follow them on Instagram. Follow them on Facebook. They doing some major stuff. They got a series of concerts they doing. I'm telling you, it's a big thing. So tune in, all right?
And you can't say Miss Rose without saying what up to Brooklyn.
Brook
Brooke and Conan.
And Scrappy, DJ Scrappy Gappy.
Okay.
You know, that's how it goes down.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I also got a text from my man Zoe.
Oh, yes. Zoe. Yes, Industry Talk.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if they're coming back with the same name, but Industry Talk, the old Industry Talk.
Okay. Zoe,
Hex, they got a new team, a full team. They're about to do it again.
Okay.
You know, so y'all stay tuned for them. Of course, we got the Let's Be Clear every Saturday, 11 to 1 p.m.
Okay.
We also got the Violators coming back in January.
Okay.
Listen, there's a whole lot of surprises, too.
What about that Super?
Yo, listen, DJ Super C,
Super C.
We got to sit down, figure out the time slots for him, but he's definitely coming back, and he's going to be a major part of this team. You know, that's my man. That's my people. You know, we can't do this without including those people that helped us from day one, that was here and saw the vision.
Yes.
So there's certain people who's going to be with us on this ride that's going to be a part of what we're doing for sure.
Okay.
And Super C is one of those people.
Okay, now, so I just want to give you a heads up.
Uh-huh.
I'm not telling you too much. I'm just going to give you a little, let you know that I'm getting ready for you, Al. The mixes are being set up.
Oh,
here
boy.
Here we go. I'm not out.
Oh,
I'm not
man.
Telling you nothing. The mixes are getting set up. I just want you to know that I'm coming for you, Al. For you.
Wait. Hold on. Let me stop you for a minute.
Well, tell people what's going on right now.
It's been a year since you challenged me.
I just told you.
DJ.
Wait. I just told you. I do my homework and I master my craft before I throw myself out there.
But wait a minute. You said you was already a DJ.
I'm a DJ on the
1200. DJ Cheerios,
okay,
right?
Wait. On the 1200.
It don't matter.
It does matter.
No, it doesn't matter. Because right. I used to DJ on the 1200 too.
Okay, let me show you something. So, if you're a DJ and you're out there and you're listening,
right?
I want you to understand what I'm saying. And I know you understand what I'm saying if you're a DJ. I have real big hands, as you can see. Real big hands.
And they ain't no bigger than mine,
so stop it. So, for me to DJ on the 1200s, it was good because it was a big controller, right? With these little controllers.
Was it a controller or was it a turntable?
A turntable, but now they got these little controllers. And my hand was too big for it. Like the one we got over here, my hands are too big for it. So
excuses,
I had to set.
Excuses.
Okay, so I had to set the situation up right.
Excuses, people.
Okay, so now the situation is right. I'm setting up my mixes. When I'm doing this, I'm putting the boards, the music together, and everything is right. So I'm calling.
Wait. Are you putting it together or somebody put it together?
No, don't do that.
Somebody
do
put
that.
It together for
no.
you.
No. See, that's what I'm doing. I'm hearing up songs and I'm putting them in the era that we came up. I got 80s music, I got 90s music, I got what we got going on now.
Okay.
I got So I'm putting them minutes per beat, and I'm getting them songs that's closer to the song. So
you line them up per beat. That way, you just can't go off the top and do something.
No, well, right? It's gonna be tough.
Listen, hold on. Let me say something to you. Back in the day,
I'm telling you,
we were DJing. We went to the crate. We pulled something out.
Right.
We made it work.
Right.
We ain't lining it up.
But I'm lining it up right now because I'm setting it up. Nah, get back over here. All right. Let's get back to the next topic. Okay, so. Okay, so let's talk about your man Cheetos, man. What's going on, Al? Talk to me, Al. What's going on with Cheetos, man?
Cheetos is done.
Okay. Do you think he will be out?
I don't think they're going to impeach him, but
not,
he's done.
I don't think. You know what? I think they're going to let, like you said, let this play out. Let him get out. But I just think that he should have been impeached. I really believe that he should have been impeached.
Well, here's the thing, man. There's a lot of things that went on with him, and people knew what he was doing. So, of course, when you things like that happen, it's definitely a conspiracy.
Mm-hmm.
Those who are involved, those who are not speaking up, those who turn a blind eye to it, all of that plays a major factor. But again, there's the powers that be that he's advising him and giving him advice on what to do and how to do it. And they stood by him through this whole thing. So, again, if you let him go, then that whole team got to go, too.
Okay. Now, you see that we said Artie Green just hit me up. And
what's up, Artie?
He just hit me up with a great idea. He said, what's not being covered out here in the sports world is high school sports.
Oh, yeah.
So he was saying he would like to either get a show or give us names of people that we should be watching in high schools going toward, you know, going towards college and towards the NBA, so we can let people know who they are before they even get there.
So here's what I got to say to you, Artie. If that's what you're passionate about, man, let's sit down, let's politic, man. Let's create a show around all the things that you're talking about so that you can have a look at the people who wants to see that, okay? Let's make it happen, man. It's business. Let's do it. It's easy.
Okay, and I mean, once again, we get a lot of suggestions on what we should do, and that was definitely a good suggestion. You know, like, I've never seen that, right? You know,
yeah.
As far as coverage now, but
before you go, I just want to say that to Artie that it shows the support that we get up here,
right?
You know, they see that we busy, we doing a lot, but then they like, you know, what I would like to see at iAccess. Okay, and that's the thing, and that's what makes us different from everybody else. That's what sets us apart. Because
we can
listen to our constituents out there, and they can show us a need, and we can supply that need.
Okay.
You know?
Now, as far as this music industry right now, we got a, like I said, I got this artist that I'm working with right now. Once again, I'm going back to the funk. So I heard, we talked about this a couple of weeks ago. I heard a group in the last 2 weeks, that's trying to do what we talked about. They're trying to put together a funk band. They had auditions a couple of weeks ago, down at Smash Studios.
Right.
A friend of mine went down there. He said it didn't go well because a lot of these artists these days feel they're so independent. I want to be in charge. Funk.
Right.
Is a thing that where it's a group of everybody come together. There's not one. I mean, there's one leader, like George Clinton was the leader, but
right.
He had his team.
Right.
So explain to people how we can get a real funk team or get that back to where it was at when it comes to funk, because it seems like people are really lost when it comes to that.
Yeah, well, the thing is, what's good about what I'm hearing on some music, you're hearing the underlining filter of it.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And the good thing is that people have an ear for funk music, because funk music makes you want to get up and dance, period. It gives you a certain emotion, like really make you want to get into that groove.
Uh-huh.
So you got an artist by the name of Lizzo, a female artist by the name of Lizzo. A lot of her stuff has an underlining funk ground to a foundation to it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So for us to be able to put something together, we have to find somebody who understands the history of funk music, what it looks like, and how to let that intertwine with today's music and today's people out there on the level of what they like music on. You know what I mean? Because it's not going to ever have the resurgence that it had back in the days, but still, that underlying foundation of what funk does to music is awesome, man.
Okay.
The bass lines, the drums, you know, the crazy horn arrangements, okay? The vocal arrangements, they're just phenomenal. And you don't find that in all music.
Now, when you go back to your musical segment,
right?
I want you to go into some James Brown. You know what song has been sticking on my mind? I want you to hit me some old James Brown and some old Parliament today, because that's how we start out the show. Give me some shout outs right there.
All right, what's good?
Right there. We're going from there down. Okay.
Baba Jean, what's going on?
Okay.
Joanna Lee.
That's my sister right there.
Curtis Palmore.
What's going on?
Lee Richardson.
You already? We doing it. We doing it up here at our Access Radio. Karen.
Luana Ward.
Yes, Karen.
Danny. Yes. Hankerson, I'm sorry. Whitley. Karen Whitley, what's going on?
Yes.
Yeah, so we see y'all.
Everybody, thank you for tuning in. We watching. It's a good show going on. Okay, so now, I don't like to keep talking about the same thing that everybody else was talking about. But
wait a minute. You asked me to say a prayer earlier.
I'm going to say the prayer after this next little thing, then we're going to go into the prayer.
Well, let's get the prayer out the way so that everything going on after that could be blessed.
Okay, go ahead.
All right?
But let me tell you something. Let's get this straight right now. If I say let's do it after, because this is the Big Rich the Ruler show, we'll do it after. I'm going to let you get this one, right? Because it's a prayer.
But let me say this. This is Big Rich the Ruler show.
Okay.
But Big Rich, you ain't bigger than the man upstairs.
Oh my God.
You know what I'm saying?
Let's go.
He put something on my heart, like, let's do this prayer now.
Okay.
Let's do the prayer now. So, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to you, your humble servants, as always, giving you all the praise and glory, asking you to bless this day.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you
mm-hmm.
for giving us a space to continue the dream and the opportunity that you have placed on this team. I Access family is so thankful to you, Lord, for always providing, making a way, looking out when we thought things weren't going to go the way that you had already planned and foreseen it for us. You showed us again with confirmation and affirmation that once you put your hand in something, nothing but success and victory could come out of it. So we thank you right now. We thank you for our listeners. We thank you for the support of each and every person that has joined us and those who are with us. We thank you for the partners, and we thank you for life itself, God. And we ask for these things, and we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us say amen.
Amen. Amen on that one. Yeah. All right, yo, I got to give a special shout out to my brother again, once again. Real Bronx, what's going on, man? That's love, love. You already know. You family in the building. Miss Renee, hey, Miss Renee, I need to speak to you, Miss Renee, so I'm going to give you a call as soon as this show is over. We need to talk about something. I got everything lined up. We're ready to go. This is a new reality show that we're working on. Miss Renee, we ready to go. Okay, so Al, I don't like to keep talking about what everybody talks about, but this, one of my favorite shows right now, I got two favorite shows that I watch. Black Ink is my favorite show.
Okay.
Black Ink in New York. Mm-hmm. Season them. And once again, we was blessed to have him at the radio station.
Absolutely. Black Caesar came through his team.
Yeah, and I need to get him back up at the show because that's my favorite show right now. Black
Ink. Okay, got you.
Loving hip hop. The one that just bothered me right now, and I heard System talk about it before I walked in the door, is with this Little Fizz Omarion.
Right.
Now, we can't really say how people feel. Now, I know, once again, it's crazy to me because, once again, they was in the same band. That don't mean they had to like each other.
Right.
So let's clarify everything that's going on. That don't mean they have to like each other because it was in the same bag. It was about that bag. This is how Fizz is making the sound. Mm-hmm. Omarion is a bigger artist than Fizz, so he felt like, okay, you know what? You know, cross that line, I'm gonna cross this line. And he shut that whole, you know, that whole little tour down with them, and it's just Omarion now.
Right.
What's more important, love or the bag?
Well, love is always utmost important, and I'm going to tell you why.
You know the whole situation? You know it?
Yeah. Okay. I'm familiar with it.
What's going on? I need you to know.
Baby mama drama and all that.
Okay,
yeah.
Let's go. Okay.
So here's the thing. If you love yourself
right,
the way God loves you,
mm-hmm,
then you would not disrespect your fellow man.
Okay.
In any way, shape, or form, because you wouldn't want that done to you.
Okay, so let's get this clear now.
All right, we're talking about love.
Love.
Before the bag.
For the bag.
For the bag.
Let's go.
So, and if you love someone, right?
Right.
And you claim to love them, if there's a way that both of y'all can be wealthy together, then that should be done out of love.
Okay.
Okay. Now, if it's not done with love in the equation, then you're a liar and you're not loving.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Because again, the word says you can't claim to love God and not love his children.
Okay.
And if you love God, then you have to love his children because he loves us unconditionally.
Okay, okay.
And he was like, if that's what I'm teaching you, then you have to be an example to each and every person, especially when you're in the limelight and people are watching you.
Okay, so my thing is, like I said, I watch the show every week, and I'm really into the show.
Right.
I'm not going to judge nobody because there's only one person that can judge us.
Right.
Okay, but my thought about what happened on there, I just feel like Fizz went about it wrong. This is somebody who you get a bag with.
Right.
Plus, you don't watch this man's children grow up.
Right.
That was your,
right,
you know, like, so.
Right.
I don't, once again, it's beautiful to have a relationship where you love somebody, but I don't think I could love my next man's girl. I'm talking about me. Fizz, you did what you did. It's whatever it is, what it is. I'm talking about me.
Right. But Rich, I'm with you. But here's the thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you and I are breaking bread together, after a while, there's a portion of that breaking bread that we are like family.
Right.
And one thing my uncle taught me years ago is like, you don't sleep with family.
Right.
So whether it's male or female, mm-hmm, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. They in that circle of family, you don't cross that line and they've crossed that line.
Okay. And once you cross that line, sometimes you can't go back.
Sometimes you can't go back.
Okay.
Because I'm not saying you're not supposed to forgive people. But it's just some things that happens that don't make no sense. Why would you do that?
Right.
There's other pickings out there.
Right.
Why would you take from in on a circle with family?
Okay.
You know what I mean? Don't make no sense.
Right.
You know?
So once again, like I said, I don't want to dwell on it. I just had to speak on it. Because once again, go get set up for some musical break. For a musical break.
All right.
I need some James in my life. You know what I mean?
Right. Hey, James.
Yeah. Oh my God. Here we go. But on a real note, I just was saying, like I said, to me, I just think that if it's scripted and that's how they did it, to me they did it wrong because you done made too many people not dislike this Fizz dude. I just think once again, forget the bag. It's the brotherhood that y'all had that y'all shouldn't have, you shouldn't have crossed that line. Sis, Joanne, what's going on? Let me read what you said. Okay. Well, I just feel like once again, if it's all about the bag, then what you did was right, is right. That's on you. But if it's about the brotherhood, it's about, growing up together all them years and being around each other. I just felt like that was crazy. So once again, I just want to say I had to give my opinion on it. Once again, I got to get Black Ink, my man Caesar, up here because once again, that's my favorite show right there, Black Ink, because like I said, it's all about good reality. Speaking of good reality, I got my partner up here, my man Pro, and I got to talk to him about this reality show. I need him to, he's the best. What do you do? How you say it, Pro? What was it when you spoke over? Voiceover. He was the best voiceover that I ever seen in the game right now. I'm working on this new reality show. It's all about music. No gangster, none of that. It's all about music. So once again, y'all get ready for it. The new Big Rich reality show is coming. I got DJs. I got producers. You're going to see new type of talents. You're going to see people trying to get on the show. It's going to be real crazy. And then it's going to wind up. The end result is going to be a showcase. And we're going to work on this showcase. I got to sit down with the whole team and see what's best for us to do this showcase and where we can do it. And that's how the show going to end. I'm just going to do one season of starting out all the way to the end. Once again, what's up, Mike Black? What's going on? Joanne, what's going on? Keisha, what's going on? Val, how you doing? Aunt Beck, what's going on? Everybody's chiming in right now. Al, are you tuned up over there? Okay, well, let me talk about something else then. Let's talk about the word love. Somebody said to me this week, Rich, love ain't nothing but a four-letter word. And for many a years, I felt like that. I don't feel like that no more. Such thing as love is real. Love is real, and you have to find the right person to feel the same thing. Everybody always say Big Rich the Ruler. You the love doctor, you the love guru and all that stuff. Why you never in love? I don't tell my business. I don't speak my business. But love is a good feeling. That's all I want to say. And everybody needs to know that. Like, Emar, what's going on? Once again, happy birthday to my man, Sai. What's going on to my man? Oh, man. You got my man, Cloud Black. What's going on? How you been? It's been a minute. Who's that? Okay, Diana, what's going on? It's been a while since you tuned in. Sharon McNeil, North Carolina, stand up. Maxton, I'll be down south in about 2 more weeks, yo. Little family get together. Pajama jammy joint. Nisha, hey, Nish, what's going on? I see you. Tawana, how you doing? Cousin Shell, Tori, Duke, Mean Gene, everybody, what's going on, Maxton? I'll be down in about 2 more weeks, but we're getting ready for this Big Rich the Ruler musical break. We're going to go musical. Let me see who else is. Damn, the lines is going crazy right now. Lisa, it's been a minute. Who's that? Oh, snap. Okay, I hear you. Pam, what's going on? PC ladies, how you been? What's going on? Who's that? Oh, man. Wendy, what's going on, Wendy? And like I said, we got a lot of different shows coming in. One of the shows, once again, I'm glad to be saying is. My man Chris the Boss, he should be coming with the Chris the Boss Radio. OB Music is coming. We got my man Dame coming. We got my man Brian. So the DJs are coming up. I got to holler at my man Danny D. Danny D told me when we ready, let him know. So Danny D, we about to holler at you. Knuckles, what's going on? What's going on? All the DJs, E. Kim, Brucey B, what's going on? Let's talk about, I'm waiting for my man, Uncle Burn to call me. Matter of fact, let me hit Uncle Burn, tell him to call in so he can make that major announcement because I don't want to leak it if it's not time to leak it yet. And Bronx Day is July 16th through 19th. We down there. Milk, Cam, what's going on? We setting up for that. Like I said, everybody just getting ready for the up and coming events. Don't forget my sister's birthday party that we talked about earlier, Rose. We're going to give y'all more information about that before we end the show. Conan, we need some music from Conan. I need some new music. So, Conan, if you're listening, hit me up with some new music. I need that. And I want you to help even help me with this some new reality show, because I want you to be judging on some of the stuff that I got coming through in the next couple of weeks. So, Big Al, are you ready yet? 2 minutes. Okay, 2 minutes. Let me take my glasses off. What's up, Virginia? I hope you're feeling better because you were sick for a little minute. Who's that? Siobhan. Okay. Siobhan, you from New York. Okay, I see you. Cousin Dale. Dawn. Hey, how you doing? Virginia, once again, prayers with you. Prayers up. Make sure that you feel good. What is Rick's... Oh, man. It's something girls. Right, black girls. That's where I'm going to leave here. That's my man Rick Spot, man, over there by White Plains Road. Black Girls Seafood. If you haven't been there, you need to get there. Google it. The address is guaranteed to be the hitting this soulful little joint that I've been out in a minute. Okay. And I want to give a special shout out to my brother, Will Bronx. I seen it on the book. His birthday was yesterday. Happy birthday, Will Bronx, from the whole iAccess Radio family. You know you family up here all day, every day. So once again, I want to give a special birthday shout out. And if you have a birthday or know somebody with a birthday and you want to get them shout out on the radio, give me a call at 347-708-0216. iAccess Radio, Big Rich the Ruler Show. Lil Al, are we tuned up yet? And my man Cy, once again, Cy, happy birthday. God bless you for to see another year. Oh, okay, Will, I see you. Yeah. Well, matter of fact, yo, Will, give me a call and let me know what you're doing tonight, man. Maybe we can stop by and have a little drink before, you know, I go in. Tomorrow, I'm going to be up at, play the game. I'm going to be over at Glenwood's, but play the game tomorrow. I see Brucey B's next. So I'm going to stop by there tomorrow and show love. I want to give a special shout out to my man, Biz. Biz, I watch your links all the time, man. You definitely got it going on. You and Tony Cakes, y'all definitely, I love your shows. You and Tony, y'all keep it 100 real, and I love that. Last night was my man Dave Shue, Gatsby party. I wasn't able to make it down there, but I seen the pictures. Yo, Dave Shue, thank you for showing love at all times too, man. That's another brother where I can call at any time, and he got my back. I want to give a special shout out to all the shows that's up here. You just seen a little while ago, Let's Be Clear, my sisters. We got Rose and them. We got a lot of good shows up here. The Violators are coming back. Like I said, Super C's on his way back. Industry Talk, they might got a new name. Chris the Boss should be making that contract next week. And like I said, we got a special person coming through here today to contract up with us. So we doing pretty good. We doing real good. We making them moves. And if you're a show and you're out there and you want to become part of the iAccess Radio family, hit us up. We got spots. We got dates. Just hit us up and you can come on and we, you know, go through the whole procedure of trying to get you on the iAccess Radio family, and it's there. Once again, Al, are you with me? Let's go.
Payback! Payback! That is! Payback! record is.
Repent! Big fat backstabbing.
Oh no!
The brother, get ready. That's a fight. Get ready, you mama. For the big payback. The big pay.
This is for
Connie.
This is for Atlanta.
Took my money, got my honey. Don't want me to see what you're doing to me.
This is for Los Angeles.
We'll be right back.
Big Rich the Ruler, I'm back in the building. Hey, once again, the new iAccess radio station, we're looking for interns, we're looking for engineers, we're looking for people who just want to be a part of the staff. So if you want to be part of the iAccess radio team, hit us up. Once again, hit me up, hit Big Al up, hit Pro up. We definitely need more staffing up here. For more information, you can get in touch with me personally, Big Al personally, or you can call us at 347-708-0216. Hey, Al, is your mic on? Let them know the link where they can get in touch with you at, so we can definitely get these interns up here. Like I said, if you're an engineer, if you know an engineer, if you want to be part of the staff, you know, street team, anything that we need right now, receptionists, all that. If you want to be a part of the iAccess Radio family, hit up the iAccess Radio team. Once again, you can give us a call. Big Al, give them your info once again. Okay, well, once again, 347-708-0216. North Carolina, I'll be down there in 2 weeks. We're going to do this family thing, so let's get it going. Working on this music situation is a good thing. So if you have music and you want your music to be heard, hit me up. I'll get your music played. If you know any artists that's ready, give us a call. If you have a show and you want to be part of the iAccess Radio family, DJs, MCs, comedians, whoever you are.
Journalists, you got a podcast. You do newsworthy stuff. You have a blog, whatever it may be, hit us up. And the best way to do it is to go to www.iaccessradio.com. Go to our careers page. On the careers page, you can fill out application. You can submit information to us about what you would like to do, and we'll get back to you. That's the best way to get in touch with us, because that way we'll have all your information and we can start emailing each other back and forth. And that way you'll be able to get in the loop and understand what it is that we offer and how it might line up with the iAccess brand.
Okay. Now, what does Christmas mean to you?
Christmas, oh man. Christmas is a reminder of me of the day that God promised us that Christ was coming into the world.
Okay.
But not just that day, but that everybody recognized that the Savior was here.
Okay.
And that day, we kind of take it as for granted as giving gifts and things of that nature. But I think for me, it's more of me paying homage and giving honor to our Lord and Savior.
Okay. Is it more for the kids, or is it more for adults, or is there a certain age where you should stop saying I'm going to get something for Christmas? What is Christmas? And not
well, again, Christmas shouldn't really be about buying people gifts all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It should be really having a thankfulness for life in its abundance.
Okay,
because that day allows us to go out and spend money, so we got to be thankful for the wealth that comes with it. We got to be grateful for our ability to be able to do something for somebody else and not have an expectation of it.
Okay.
It gets bad when we have an expectation and somebody's coming and you talking about, oh, you didn't do nothing for me for Christmas. What about the rest of the days of the year?
Okay.
You still living. You still here. You're still a part of this world. So if I can bless you on Christmas, I should be able to bless you any other day.
Okay.
It shouldn't have to be a special day. But that's why I say people are misinformed or ignorant to what that day is really about. That day is really about what the prophecy was, what the message was, what Isaiah spoke about. Well, when they spoke about the Messiah coming, you know, it was found to be a promise that came to terms and came true. So we have to recognize that. And those that don't recognize, they misrepresent the Christmas as it is.
Okay. Let's go to another word. Love.
Love.
Okay. So let me just say something. The reason I brought this up, because I was on the phone this week with the young lady, and we was all talking about different words.
Mm-hmm.
Love was a word that came up. People misuse the word love. So my meaning of love, to me, love is more than just a feeling.
Right,
more than this emotion. It's a connection.
Okay.
Like, say, so when you, all right, perfect example. So when you reconnect with somebody who you always loved, and, you know, y'all get back together, y'all talk and all that stuff, that's a different kind of love.
Right.
There's a love that you can love your wife. There's a love, but that reconnection love. When you love somebody who you always loved and you get that chance, that's the love we was talking about.
Okay.
Now, that love right there is so special to me. When you get that boomerang effect where it goes away and it comes back.
Right.
You get to learn a person. You get to mold a person, get to see what a person is really about. That's the love I'm talking about. Tell me what your meaning of love is.
So I'm gonna piggyback off of what you said, that boomerang effect, that love boomerang for somebody that you always had that feeling for you. But see, the important thing about that is that love never dies.
Okay,
love always dwells where it's supposed to dwell. Mm-hmm. Okay, love, you may have a moment where you're upset with somebody, but that don't stop you from loving them.
Okay.
You know, there may be a time period that goes by 10, 15 years that you
might.
Caller, you're on the air. Caller, you're on the air. What's good?
Yo, what's the deal?
Yo,
who's Big Rich, calling? Big Al.
What's going on?
What up?
That voice is familiar. Who's that there? Oh, that's Will Brawls. That's Will Brawls.
Yo, what's up, man?
I caught that. Will Brawls, what up, boy?
What's the deal, man? How y'all?
I just want to say happy birthday to you,
yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
Happy.
You was looking real good yesterday.
Man.
I seen you on the book.
Uh-huh.
Okay, thank you.
What's going on for the night? What you doing tonight for your birthday?
Oh, no, I think we're getting up with Rose Medallion.
Okay. That's tonight?
Yeah.
Okay. It's tonight.
That's tonight.
So, what you doing tomorrow, man? Why don't you come out to Glenroy's and I get you a drink or two, man, for your birthday?
I'm going to pull up, definitely.
That's what's going on, man. Everything else is good?
Yeah, I'm good, man.
I just
making 56 look like whoa, you know what I mean?
Yeah. That's fine. I remember those days, Will. Believe me, I remember,
man.
Oh,
my goodness.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, you remember those days.
Yeah, I wish I could go back to that, bro.
Hey, but once again, from the family, man, thanks, man. You know, you part of the family from day one, man. You brother to the end.
Absolutely. Appreciate it.
And we love you to death, brother. And we just want to say, man, thank you. And God bless you to see another year. And keep in touch with the iAccess Radio family. Matter of fact, you need to come through, man.
Man.
On that grand opening, we know how you pop bottles. So we need you up here, y'all.
I'm there. Just let me know.
I want iAccess. I want to know when we're going to get that Will Bronx show, man. We need a Will Bronx show up here.
You know what's crazy?
But look.
Let me tell you something.
Hold on. About to put something together, right? Yo, pro, we about to put something together, right?
you know what's funny? Because if you ever watch Will, he's always with an old school artist. He knows all of them. So
that
would be something easy for the Will man to put together, yo. He knows everybody.
Right.
Man. I'm blessed, man.
Okay.
All right. Well, just want to say once again, happy birthday. And
thank
God
you, man.
Bless you, yo. All right?
Thank you. Love you guys, man.
Love
keep
too,
it up, man. I hear you. iAccess Radio, what up?
You all ready? So let's get back to your words of love. Okay, go ahead.
So again, for me, love comes in all shapes, sizes, and forms. Okay? You can love and hate. You can love in pleasure. You can love in joy. You can love when you're discombobulated. You can love when things don't look good. You can love when your best friend turns to be your enemy. You know what I'm saying? So love is something, man, that encompasses all parts of what we do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just how it's delivered. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? A lot of people turn to you and say nasty things. They're like, you don't love me. But here, you can't tell me how I feel about you.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You can't tell me where my love resides when it's concerning you. You know what I mean? So again, that love has so many different dynamics to it. But really, when you love unconditionally, then it will show at all times through everything.
Wow.
Through everything.
Like I said, with that boomerang effect, when you love somebody all your life, and then you get to tell them how you really feel. And, you know, you really get to open up and find out a person and really learn that person, man. That's, to me, that's the best feeling. Like,
right, absolutely.
You can, all right, perfect example. Like when somebody walk on the aisle and say, you know, I do.
Right, right. Right.
Do you really know that person 100%? But as time go on, you get to learn that person.
Absolutely.
But if you love somebody from the door and you learn them, that's the best love, man.
Yeah,
that's
yeah. But what's good about that, any type of love in that lane, man, is that you saying to that person that no matter what it looked like today,
right,
I'm willing to grow and move forward with
and
you.
And that's what it is.
I'm willing to build with you.
That's what it is.
Okay, no matter what obstacles we face, we're going to overcome those hurdles. And we're going to rise to the occasion so that we can love at a level like never before.
And when you, like I said, when you're in love, when you talk to somebody and you speak to them, and every time you talk to them, you get a feeling. And, you know, mm-hmm. you know, that's, once again, so I was talking to this young lady because she was like, love, doctor, you know, I'm in love. And I'm like, wow, okay, so explain to me how you feel about this love. And when we was talking about it, I understood everything she was saying.
Okay,
you know
that's what's up, yeah.
Now, blind dates.
Okay.
So somebody hit me the other day and said, love, doctor, she's going on a blind date. She said, blind date is the same thing as meeting somebody online because you never know what you're going to see.
Absolutely.
Okay. I don't agree with that. You just said absolutely, but I don't agree with that, Al.
Absolutely. Let me show you why.
No, let me tell you something.
Have you ever seen that program called Fish?
Fish, no.
Yeah. So it's a reality show,
mm-hmm.
and there's these two guys, and what it is there's always a couple people who they meet online, but they never get a chance to really see who these people are.
Oh, you mean catfish?
Yeah, catfish.
Oh, that's
right.
Different. Yo, catfish. Yeah,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, yeah. I just call it fish for short.
Yeah, okay.
Right. So again, a lot of times,
it's not the
people
person.
Present themselves as something totally different.
Right.
Right. And then when they get to meet them, it's like, wow, this wasn't who I thought it was.
Mm-hmm.
You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So again, that blind date is the same thing. You never know until you meet that person.
Hold on.
Person in person.
Let me tell you something. Now, a blind date is. Yeah, yeah, okay.
You don't know, Rich.
Right,
you just
right.
don't know.
Okay, yeah, I'm
you can meet somebody online. You still don't know.
Okay.
Especially if. That person like, yo, let's meet such and such, and then they stand you up.
Okay.
And people are so gullible nowadays. They're like, oh, I had a situation. Can we meet again?
Okay, give me a couple of shout-outs right quick. Starting from there.
Ingrid, what's going on, baby? How you doing?
Okay.
Clifton Jones, I see you, brother.
Okay.
Alan Rodriguez.
Somebody from VA.
And Deborah calling from GA. What's up?
Yo, boy, you fall with you, yo?
I don't know. It's kind of dry in here, man. I need some water or something.
Whoa! You need a whoa. Okay. Okay. But now, let me show you something. Okay, perfect example. So, there's a young lady. I once again, this is what I do. I come live and tell y'all how it is. There's a young lady who I have never met yet.
Never Virginia met. Taylor, we see you.
Never met yet. Conversations is great. We talk about everything. And then, one day,
Monique Little.
One day, we got to the conversation, and I said to the person, "You know what? I love talking to you on the phone."
Pamela Williams.
I'm talking to you, man.
I'm listening, man.
So
I'm shouting the people out as you go. Go ahead.
Okay, so we start talking about that type of love, that different type of love.
Michael Grant.
Man, I'm going to stop till you finish, man.
All right. I just want to listen, people. We really appreciate y'all tuning in, supporting us, what we do up here at iAccess, Big Rich the Ruler Show, all our shows. I'm just so excited about the new spot, about what we're about to do.
That's right.
The vision is crazy. Y'all don't understand.
Yo.
The vision is crazy. When we talk about building a brand, we're going to be major league out there. And y'all going to say, I remember when.
Yes.
You know? When y'all see our logo standing beside Pepsi and Chase and Cadillac and all of that, y'all be like, yeah, I remember when.
Can you love somebody you never met?
It's possible.
Okay.
It depends on what type of communication that you have with that person on the regular.
The question that the lady asked me was, love, doctor. Can you love somebody you have never met? Now, I'm talking from my experience. I have done it before. Met the person, and after I met him, I was like, wow, it was everything I expected from the person. Some people say you can't do it. You can't love somebody that you have never met. You talk to somebody every day, you text somebody every day, boom, boom, boom. Can you fall in love with that person?
See, this is the one thing that people got to understand. Love is also spiritual.
Okay,
and when you connect it with somebody spiritually, you don't have to be in the same room with them. You don't have to be in that same environment, because that spirit travels through all things.
Okay.
So again, if you meet somebody and y'all hit it off spiritually and the love comes, then it's still genuine.
Okay.
You know? Just like the word says, we must love God in spirit, we must worship God in spirit and in truth. We never met God. You know what I mean? But it's his spirit. Mm-hmm. That we understand that brings us love, and his spirit shows us what he has done for us and what he can do for us. Okay, it's the same difference. Now okay. I'm saying that people are like God, but that spirit that you're able to read in other people, that's what we recognize. That's what we're attracted to, because we are spiritual beings.
So once again, you can fall in love with somebody
absolutely
that you never
Rich.
Met.
Absolutely.
Okay, because now, just like you said with the catfish thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now. When you watch shows like that and you see stuff like that, it makes you go, wow, okay, this really does happen in life.
Yeah, but the crazy thing is these people be so deep head over heels in love with these other people.
Mm-hmm.
And they bugging like, yo, she ain't answering my call today. I call her 10 times. Ah, they going through it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So you can't tell me that that's not real.
Okay.
It's not real.
So... to answer the question for the last time.
Absolutely,
you
yes.
You can
absolutely
fall in
yes.
love with somebody
yes.
who you never met.
Absolutely.
You can fall in love with somebody who
absolutely,
you don't see
yes.
every day.
Mm-hmm.
That you don't see every day.
Mm-hmm.
You can.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. I just want to make sure these things, because when people come to me with these questions, you gotta be able to answer these questions. Now, let me show you something else. Okay, so.
See, Alan Rodriguez says yes.
I see. Uh-huh. But once again. When you love somebody from afar, it could be close, it could be from afar. But when you love somebody, how do you know when it's unconditional?
This is how you know it's unconditional.
Because see, I'm a love doctor.
But here's that's the question.
The love doctor gets a lot of questions all the time from the ladies. So I got to be able to answer these questions spiritually and mentally.
Okay.
So now I'm going to the spiritual side of this word love.
Right, right.
Because the love doctor can say, I'm in love right now.
Okay, good. I'm happy for you, brother.
I didn't say that. I said that. I said, I love Dr. Can't
you said you
say
can say it, and you
no,
said
I
it.
I love right now.
You said you can
there
say it,
we
and
go.
You said
don't try to flip
so
my script.
So if you say that you can say that, and then you say it,
okay.
then that means that's what it is,
but
right?
But damn it, I'm in love.
Okay.
Damn it, I'm in love. Let's go.
Okay.
Now, go ahead.
So unconditional love is this. Let's say you set up a date with
mm-hmm.
somebody.
Mm-hmm.
You love them. Y'all got a little something going on. And they disappoint you and don't show up for the date.
Doug Oliver, what up, boy?
But then when you speak to them again, you don't really give them a whole lot of questions, but you're like, okay, we could do it another time.
Mm-hmm.
That's unconditional. That means you're trusting in that person. If that's what it is that you told me, why you couldn't show up, that's what it is. It doesn't matter. I still love you.
Okay.
I'm still willing to rock with you, okay? Then there's other situations. Perfect example. There are men and women who cheat, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that person that they cheat on finds out about it. And they willing to say, you know what? I love you so much that I'm willing to forgive you for this transgression.
Okay.
And they continue to rock on. That's love.
Okay.
There are people out there that says, oh, if that was me, I would have left them yesterday. But you never know until you're in that situation.
Because
a lot of people that I know, when they wind up in situations like that, or having children out of wedlock with somebody else, like I wouldn't stay, but because of the love and because of what they see in that person and because of how they feel about that person, they wind up staying and try to work it out.
Okay, so now let me just say this. You just said, hold on. We're going to come back to where love. I need you to give this person a special shout out, Doug Oliver.
Doug Oliver, what's up, D.O.? What's up, baby?
Now, Doug Oliver is another show that's supposed to be coming up here to the iAccess. I'm glad you tuned in, Doug. Give me a call so we can sit down and make this work. Doug Oliver, you know Doug.
I know Doug, yeah.
Doug,
absolutely.
Yeah, Doug, we got to get you to the show, man.
Hold on. Doug says,
Lord.
If someone says yes, they don't know what love is. Doug, we need you to call up here and explain that.
Yeah. Doug, you know the number? 347-708-0216. 347-708-0216. And explain why you said that. But now you said the word cheat.
Right.
Now, I'm telling you, I'm going on my past experiences.
Okay.
If you cheat on me, I can't love you no more. All right. I'm sorry. There's no such thing as cheating in love.
Okay, so let me ask you a question. I hear what you're saying, so let me ask you.
You cheat on me, right. I can't love you no more.
So what you're saying to me, if somebody cheat on me, you can't be in a relationship with them anymore.
No.
Do you stop thinking about that person?
No, you'll never stop thinking about them.
Hold on, wait. Let me answer you.
Hold on. I've only been in love two times in my life.
Oh, here we go.
No, man. This is real.
Two times.
And I was married for a moment. God rest her soul.
Uh-huh.
That was one person. Another person, know who she is.
All right. Okay.
I was in love two times in my life. That person.
So all those other relationships you had, and you told the woman you loved them, that means you didn't love them. I'm talking about in love.
Like you're talking about.
I'm going to ask you a question.
My relationships, that I love people, I love them.
Hold on.
But I'm talking about that real love, that Mary J. real love shit.
Oh, man, here you go.
Two times in my life.
Only two times.
I was in real love. And that one person that I was really in love with, besides my wife.
Artie Green, we see you. He's going to give you that call.
Cheated on me.
Wow.
So, can I love that person again to go back? No, I don't. I'm like Doug on that one. No. If you cheat on me, I can't go back. There's no way, bro, because you cheated on me. Because every time I see you, I'm going to think about you slept with somebody else. You was with somebody else. So, can I go back to that? Hell no, you might be in the bathroom. I'm gonna tear your ass up while I'm thinking about what you
But here's the thing, that's some people can't endure that. That's some people who's willing to say, you know what?
Well, I'm not one. The love doctor, the love guru, I cannot do that. If you cheat on me, I cannot.
It's not for everybody, man. You're right.
So you could?
For me, yes.
Oh my God.
I just have a forgiving heart, man. That's it. I'm sorry. You know why? I'm gonna tell you why, because we all mature at different levels.
Okay.
You know, we all grow at different levels. And I can't hold you accountable for something that you did 10, 15 years ago and we living in today. Or if you know that you did something out of emotion and you wasn't thinking, I can't hold you against that.
Mm-mm.
I can't put that brand on you and hold that to you for the rest of your life.
Let me ask you a question. So every time you're making love to that person, you don't think that comes back to mind?
If I'm thinking that way, of course.
Okay.
But if I'm willing to say, you know what, I'm gonna look at this thing from a different light.
What different light is it? Somebody else was sleeping with your lady. What other different light? It happens all the time. No, sir. It happens all the time.
However, before you get with somebody, they sometimes with somebody else.
That's before you get with them.
But it happens.
If you get with that person, we in a relationship, and we're going good, and you smash somebody else. And I find out I cannot look at you the same.
No, no smashing for you.
No, sir, because you cheated. You cheat, I'm done. I gotta go. There's no way I can be with you.
No matter what the reason was for.
Somebody smashing you. What reason could it be? So you done smash somebody. What else reason could it be?
It could be for a number of reasons. Well, here we go. We got some women who cheat because they feel like their man ain't giving them enough attention. We got brothers out there who, hold on. No, I'm not saying it makes it right. I'm not saying
we got
some brothers out there who are straight up workaholics, man. They're about that bag. They're about taking care of their family. Mm-hmm. They're about provision. Mm-hmm. They're about making sure that the finances mm-hmm. are right. The mm-hmm. home is. But the woman is like, but I don't see you.
That makes it okay.
No. And then she wound up being vulnerable one day and falling prey to some dude in this slick talk. Because she shared the situation with him. Now, she done cheated. But does that mean she don't love you? Because she was vulnerable?
Okay, let me just say this.
Remember, we human.
You right, or remember one thing I keep telling you. I live through life experiences. So I'm talking about me. I don't know how you feeling.
Wait. I got to do this. Yo, Alex Rodriguez. He says, you can't be the love doctor if you can't forgive Big Rich.
Okay.
The King Ty is watching.
Okay.
Doug Oliver is watching. Valerie McAdams is watching. Ophelia Poku is watching. Come on now. Deborah Darasaw is watching. Clifton Jones, Ingrid Campbell, Monique Little, Yvonne Owens, Pamela Williams, Michael Grant, Virginia Taylor. We hollering at y'all. We see you, Sharon. Come on, Dawn Michelle. Come on now. They watch it, man.
They can watch me say this for the 100th time. If you cheat on me, you sleep with somebody else, I cannot be with you no more. Because every time I sleep with you, I'm going to think about You slept with somebody else.
It reminds me of that movie.
I'm sorry.
With
Brandy.
With Ty Diggs and
No, the one with Brandy.
Man.
The one with Brandy.
It was Tay Diggs. What's the guy that played in Boys from the Hood? God. And they were like brothers. They had like a brotherhood. They went to college together, school together.
Best man.
That was crazy.
Okay.
And his man slept with his girl.
Right.
And every
but
time.
That's a different thing.
Nah, ain't no different.
Whoa, that's different. No, Al.
No.
That's different, Al.
No, that's different. No, no, no.
And next time I'm on, I'm going to have a woman co-host. So the women can, somebody can talk for the women. We're gonna bring this conversation
Rich,
back up.
Man. Now
but hold on. No, stop. Let me just say that. That's a difference.
Why is it different?
Because he didn't know that he was liking the girl. That wasn't his girl when he slept with her.
Nah.
The point of the whole matter that was he was supposed to tell him. He didn't tell him. That was his boy. Remember that was they was closer friends than him and the girl getting together. Remember?
But still, that was his boy.
But they wasn't in a relationship.
It don't matter.
But the whole thing that he was mad about was you were supposed to have tell him.
Man,
you supposed to told him. I don't care what you say.
Stop it.
If a woman sleeps with when the person that I was with cheated on me and she slept with somebody else, I couldn't look at her the same. Mm. And I'm talking about.
I get you. You have a right to your feelings.
And I'm talking about to this day. Don't get me wrong. I still love that person to this day.
But that's my point. You don't stop loving.
No, you can't stop loving them. No, I ain't gonna lie.
But that's my point.
I still love
her. No matter that, you still love her.
I do.
Okay, so that's my point. Enough said.
But, Al.
I'm dropping the mic. Boom.
Yo, she cheated, Al. Well, now you ain't cheating on me. Ain't gonna be good. And we gonna be good. No.
It's done, man. It's
all right.
Done.
So, like I said, we're gonna bring this topic back up. Matter of fact, I might have my sisters or somebody stay around, or if I don't get somebody to come up here, and we're gonna talk about what is really love. Because, truthfully, I just think that if you sleep with somebody else, if you sleep with somebody else, then you don't love that person that you was with. Because there should be no reason that you slept with somebody else if you love a person. And I'm just sorry to say that. Ty, what you saying? What Ty saying?
Ty, I see you. Ty saying, word, tell him, Rich, if you drop your toothbrush on the floor in a public restroom, would you still use it? Alex Rodriguez said, point made.
Now, it's funny because Alex Rodriguez is my brother that we... These are all motorcycle guys.
Right, right.
Ty's
seeing it's over. Ty's like that's, you. He can't do it.
Yeah. Ty, that's my brother. What's the name of his motorcycle club? Ty got a motorcycle club. And Alex... It's funny because Alex is in the motorcycle club.
Okay.
We was all one at one time, the Highway Bullies.
Right.
But, you know, they moved on and got their own motorcycle club.
Okay.
But Ty, once again, my brother... That's why me and you rock with each other. Alex, I don't know what you talking about. I don't know what you talking about, Alex. But if you with a woman and she sleeps with somebody else. What up, Cousin Hess? That's my cousin from D.C.
What's up, Hess?
Cousin Dale. My thing is, if you sleep with somebody else and we're in a relationship, then what got me a minute ago was, you try to make an excuse, Al.
What about if he's a workaholic? What about if you're not spending that
because
time?
Because those are some of the excuses
gonna
that they give.
And try to make you're going.
No,
try,
I'm not trying to
you're
justify it.
And justify
no,
a woman
no,
cheating
no,
on you.
Rich. What
when
I'm
that
saying,
woman pull on her pants, and that man, once you know, that's what I'm gonna say.
What makes you
time.
Think she pulled on her pants? Maybe she had a dress
well,
on. She pulled up the skirt.
Whatever she did to get that, I can't. No, I just can't. I'm sorry.
But I just brought those topics up because those are some of the excuses that they give.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And it's kind of sad.
If you love me, there would be no excuse for what you did. Right. You're not
sleeping. Sheila, we see you.
You're not sleeping with nobody if you love me. That's it. That's just point blank. And that's the end of that story. Let's move on.
Yo, Al, we see you. We see you. We know where you're from.
Okay. This is Yo, Al, what's the name of your club, Al? Streets. Tell me the name of your club again so I can shout your team out. Okay, this is what I want to talk about before we end the show. Okay, Al. So the last conversation I had with somebody, we was talking about church.
Okay.
We was talking about church. Or we was talking about ministers. We was talking about sleeping with the congregation. We was talking about can you find love in church? Can you being on a church team, like a deacon or a deaconess or something like that, you hold higher standards than anybody that come to that church. So if you take advantage of those situations, Are you just as bad as a person? You know, once again, my family, Hester can tell you. Matter of fact, Hester's father was the biggest minister that we had in the family.
Crow MC.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Crows, that's right, the Crows. Todd Streets and the Crows, what's going on, yo? Oh,
before I not to cut you off, Sheila says that she would rather leave than cheat.
Okay.
Okay. And she says she agrees, yep.
Okay, that's what I'm telling you. Mm-hmm. If you cheat on me, then we can't rock no more. But, okay, so let's get to this last topic before we get out of here. Then we got a couple of meetings going on.
Mm-hmm.
Pastors in the church.
See, here's the thing.
Because we just had women. Oh, besides him, we just had another Catholic person step down.
Right.
Because of things. So now, once again, not saying that a pastor or a minister or a bishop or anything, they're different than anybody else. They're still people too.
Mm-hmm.
I get that. But what is going on now more these days than, well, I can't say more these days because we don't even know what's going on back in the day. But now we're having so many different situations where ministers are getting caught on baptisms and, you know, what's going on
right
now?
So first thing is social media. Okay.
It's the biggest thing.
It's the biggest thing. Social media gives us access to everything. There is nothing sacred anymore.
Right.
You know what I mean? But here's the biggest problem with us as a people. Okay. We got to understand that whether they're a bishop, a cardinal, a pastor, a deacon, an evangelist, a teacher deaconess, whatever it may be, they are still human.
Right.
And at the end of the day, the reason for them coming to the church is because most of them, majority of them, were broken in their lives somewhere. They had either some type of affliction, addiction, something that was wrong in their spirit and their life, which made them say, you know what, I need God, and I need God wholeheartedly. Okay? Just because you reach the level of pastor don't mean that you don't still work or deal with those same demons. Okay. Just because you reach the level of bishop doesn't mean that you don't still deal with those same demons and those things that you've been tempted by all your life. Mm-hmm. It's just like with a drug addict or an alcoholic. That addiction stays with them their entire life.
Okay.
They may stop drinking, but that don't mean that they're not tempted every day.
Okay.
And then
okay.
There's some who get tempted and they fall right back into that realm.
Right,
and then
right.
They got to regroup and come back and say, oh man, I fell. You know? So again, the thing is, when people fall, when people get into situations that brings a little shame on them, no matter where they are in life, we as a people got to stop judging and just help them back on to the pedestal where they need to be
mm-hmm.
at.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If that climb comes to a point where, okay, I need 4 steps this time, or next climb, I need 6 steps, whatever it may be, we need to support them. Because that's the thing that keeps them on that straight and narrow, knowing that they got people who's going to support them and they don't have to take that journey by themselves.
Okay.
And a lot of times, if you've been watching what's going on the past few years, there's a lot of pastors committing suicide. There's a lot of them that's coming out as they were bisexual, whatever. It's so many things that's going on, okay? And it's because they are human first,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
okay? And a lot of times we frown upon them or have a higher expectation of them because of the position that they hold.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, they're still human. They hurt like the rest of us.
Okay.
They go through things like the rest of us. So what is good for the goose is good for the gander. So you can't go through something one day, right, and say, wow, I really dealt with this situation. It was hard for me. And because this person's a pastor, when he go through it, you're a pastor, you shouldn't be affected like that.
Right,
that's not
right.
Right.
You know, because it's funny because in my family right now,
mm-hmm.
okay, well, my cousin Hester right there.
Right.
His father was a big preacher in North Carolina. God rest his soul.
Amen.
And my uncle Hess, right? Then my aunt Vince, which is his mother, his sister, my cousin, Shirley, and my aunt Nika.
Mm-hmm.
So right now, I got 4 ministers in my family right now.
Right.
Three. 3 pastors in my family right now.
Mm-hmm.
So church has been always big in my family. It's always been big in my family. Church. We've been in church all our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And even growing up, I said to myself, I want to be a preacher, right?
Right.
So I sat down with my aunt Nika one day, and we was talking. So this is something I'm telling you, this is serious. I felt like two times in my life I was called to ministry, right? Mm-hmm. But my aunt said to me, my aunt Nika said to me, she said, there's different type of ministry. You could be a minister of music. You could be a minister of this. You could be, what is your calling?
Right.
You got to know what your calling is before you do it.
Right, absolutely.
So, like I said, when I grew up, I watched my aunt, man. I wanted to be my Uncle Hess more than anything in the world because of, you know, him preaching and spreading the word and, you know, boom. So when my aunt hit me with that, she said, okay, you might have got a calling, but what was your calling for?
Right.
I didn't know. I couldn't answer it.
Okay.
So that's why I didn't follow and pursue that. Right. She said, if it was for you to have, it'll come back again for you.
Right.
And explain to you what your calling is about.
Right.
So once again, I'm waiting for my calling, but I just needed to know which one it was. Like she said, it could have been.
Right. So here's what I understand you're saying to me, that you have a love for wanting to serve the Lord. And right. that's a wonderful thing. But now you're asking, where's my position?
Right.
Where should I have been? So that comes with a ground, a foundation, okay, a training ground that brings you through and you see the things that you aspire to be in the ministry and the things that, you know, that you're good at and what people gravitate towards you for. So like now you're type of an evangelist because you bring people together. You bring people into a fold.
Right.
Okay. You know how to talk to people. Now imagine if everything that you do now, if you did it with the word of God behind it, you'll be evangelizing. So that's your calling.
See, and it's funny because like I was telling, like we talked about this before, and I'm glad that Pro is here to notice that us opening up this station and us able to be able to get on this microphone and thousands of people a day listening to us, we're preaching right now.
Amen. You know? Amen.
We're spreading the word right now. That's right. We just talked about love. People still hit me. My cousin had said, "What love got to do with it?" He was talking about we talk about cheating and all that stuff.
Right, right, right.
We're preaching to the people right now. This is a stage that a format that when we got together, when we sat down and put this Our Access Radio together, one of the formats that made me feel good about doing this was we'll be able to speak our own mind.
Right, right.
And that's why I say every week when I'm up here on this microphone, I'm going to speak from my experiences because this is what I'm going to preach.
Right.
I heard a preacher say one time, a very good friend of mine, he was saying that most preachers prepare their sermons before, the night before.
Right. Well, they usually start a week ahead of time.
Okay. He said he don't even know what he's going to say before he gets to the pulpit. Whatever God touches him with right then and there. Wait a minute now. Mm-hmm. What God touches with him right then and there is what he goes with. Mm-hmm. He said, no, I don't. So one day he was talking, he was preaching about going back.
Mm-hmm.
The sermon was about before you go forward, you have to go back sometime.
Mm-hmm.
And when he was talking about that, it touched me because, once again, that's what we go through sometimes. You could be going real good, but you can't forget about where you came from.
Right, absolutely.
And you always got to go back.
Absolutely.
So, once again, when it comes to ministry, like I said, my family is deep in it. I got my aunts, my grandmother was in, boy, you had, when we was growing up, Al, it's different now. My grandmother, I would hide my shoes sometimes. And she said, well, you're going to go in your sneakers. You're going to church.
Right,
you know what I'm
saying? Right.
But now, these kids don't hear the word.
Right.
And that's why they're so bad in the streets. Mm-hmm. I seen a guy the other day, a lady was crossing the street. This really touched me. A lady was crossing the street the other day with a walker. And this guy was coming down the street blasting his music. And the lady was halfway in the middle of the street. He blew the horn, scared her so much she almost fell.
Oh, that's sad.
And I said, bro, are you serious? He said, I'm in a rush. I said, that's an older lady who you should be respecting. You blowing the horn, you almost made that lady have a heart attack.
Right, right.
So I think because of the word is not as deep as it is in the homes no more.
Right.
That these kids, that's why I said they're out of control.
Well, it's the same thing like I say all the time, man. It's three things. Principle, values, and morals have been lost.
Mm-hmm.
Majority of the youngins coming up, they don't have none of those, okay? Okay. If you have 1% of one of those, it's a lot of times it'll assist you and change your life and have you look at things in a different perspective. But when you have none of those things, then people, you can't even talk to them about the Lord because they're not trying to hear it.
Right.
Because they don't have nothing to go on. So again, it starts from day one. It starts with the household, starts with the family, it starts with the community, us raising the whole community together and having a value and a principle and a moral that says this is our standard, this is the way we need to look, this is what we should be looking forward to, and this is how we should be raising our children so that they can aspire to be everything that they need to be, because at the end of the day, they are our future.
That's true. That's true. All right, Al, we had a good show today.
Absolutely.
We're going to talk about that love thing once again when I have a woman up here, because I need a woman's point of view. We always end our show one way. We have the, and it like that at all times. So I just want to thank everybody for listening. And once again, we'll be back in 2 more weeks, the Love Doctor Show. Big Rich the Ruler, a.k.a. the Love Guru. Once again, if you're an engineer, if you want to be a part of the iAccess Radio staff, DJs, anything, when anything you want to be a part of when it comes to iAccess Radio, give us a call. Al's going to tell you one more time how to get in touch with us, because we are the growing station right now, and we will be what we say we are, the station of the future, man.
That's right.
So, Al, I want you to give the info. This is, I just want to shout out everybody who watched us today. I love all of y'all. Yes, I love all of y'all. And for the cheating people out there, y'all stop that cheating, because it can really hurt some. That happened many, many years ago, and it still affects me to this day, Al. So,
yeah.
But I still love the person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what love.
Right, right.
And that's why I became, I had to go get my degree and be a love doctor.
Okay.
I got a PhD in L-O-V-E.
Okay, that's what you say.
That's what it is. I'm a love doctor, man. Okay, Al, so once again, I want you to give all the information and let everybody know, if you want to become an engineer, if you want to be anything a part of iAccess Radio, how to get in touch with us, and then let's end this show with a prayer.
Okay, so here we go. We're looking for editors. We're looking for engineers. We're looking for photographers. We're looking for people who know how to do flyers. We're looking for journalists. We're looking for people who are newsworthy. We're looking for bloggers. Okay, and if you are interested, all you have to do is go to www.iaccessradio.com. Go to our career page. Again, go to our careers page. Look into the, click on the icon and fill out the paperwork, or you could just send us an email with, if you have any questions, and we'll get back to you ASAP, okay? So that's www.iaccessradio.com, career page, all right? And we're going to end it a little something like this. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you right now. We humble ourselves, God, as we come to you, giving you all the praise and glory. Entering your gates with thanksgiving and your courts with praise because of what you do for us each and every day in our lives. We ask that you bless each and every person, God, that is listening in. Those who aspire to be what we are, God, and do what we're doing. We ask that those people who are suffering right now, God, and going through things that have ailments, whatever it may be, God, let your healing power go forth. Let the blood of Jesus touch them, God. Touch them from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet, God. Go into every part of their body, God, and whatever needs fixing, God, turn it to the days of old when they were first born, when they had fluidity in their limbs, God. We also ask, God, that you just put your angels about us, God. Dispatch them each and every day, God, and allow us to be where we need to be, living in your purpose from your promise. In the mighty name of Jesus, we end this show with a great amen.
Amen.
All right.
I know one thing. They can't say we ain't got no heat up in here. It's hot as hell up in here, yo.